Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One.
I'm over here leeching. Feel like somebody then threw me in the pool. Got all this water on me. It's all work, baby. It's all work. Live everybody. That's it. Jim Crawford getting August 19th. Coming, baby. I'm over here leaking. Feel like somebody then threw me in the pool. I got all this water on me. It's all work, baby. It's all work.
What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button, also subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. You see it. Thank you guys to the donations, or for the donations, super chats, Patreons. We're gonna get this. August 19th, it goes down. Terrence Crawford, hometown fight versus another champion in his division, Julius Ndongo, who he might not have the biggest name, but he can scrap. He has good frame, good size. and he looked good in some recent fights. His fight with Ricky Burns was most recently, and he dominated him. So that's a mutual opponent Terrence Crawford and Ndongo both share. And ironically enough, Ricky Burns, when they fought him, he was a champion. But when Crawford fought him, he was a champion at 135. When Ndongo fought him, he was a champion at 140. So this is a good fight. Four belts on the line. Terrence Crawford also has the Ring Magazine belt, and he's considered the man at 140. So this will put that extra stamp on it, if you will, if he's able to beat Julius Ndongo, who, again, he may not have the biggest name, but you got to understand and appreciate boxing, because Pacquiao, for example, just last weekend, he just got beat and hurt by a guy who was a massive underdog that even boxing reporters, journalists, vloggers like myself hadn't really even heard of. I heard of him only because they were talking about making a Pacquiao fight. That's when I started checking for him and researching. But honestly, before that point, I wasn't checking for Jeff Horn. I've interviewed other professional fighters with big names, and I asked them about the fight, and they're like, who? You look at the Bleacher Report. When they were announcing the fight, they said Pacquiao faces off against Joe Horn tonight. They don't even know his name. You know what I mean? So nothing's a given in boxing. Obviously, we want to see the most competitive fights, but I mean, these guys aren't coming to lay down. And if you really do the research, Julius Ndongo can actually scrap. So he's not just like some guy out the woodwork who has like no chance in the world. You know what I mean? Crawford is not invincible. However, the man is a dog. You guys seen the clips at the beginning. He's hard at work. That's what I like about Crawford. He's Some of you guys don't understand what I'm talking about, and I'll try my best to elaborate. Terrence Crawford is a dog, and you have to understand the fight game and or be a fighter to understand sometimes just the slang and the terminology. But when I say Terrence is a dog, it's because of his mentality. There's a lot of people who, the common casual fan, they don't really break down the sweet science. They don't break down boxing. Like, for example, I'll name a couple of dogs, like people who have dog in them, and explain what I mean. Terrence Crawford, Canelo Alvarez, Andre Ward, and Floyd Mayweather. Now, why I say they all fight different, but why I say they have dog is because they all have skills, right? But they are not going to let an opponent just get in there and do whatever they want. Even, let's say, like Canelo versus Golovkin. I expect that that's probably going to be a tough fight for both fighters, but Golovkin's not going to just go in there and unless he just lands one huge shot that Canelo can't recover from. He's not going to go in there and just not respect Canelo's game, and Canelo's not going to fight back. It doesn't happen, or at least I haven't seen it happen. He has dogs. Same thing with Ward. Andre Ward versus Sergey Kovalev. Kovalev was the known bully. He was the known power puncher. And you've seen Ward, even in the first fight, got knocked down and got up like, oh, well, he smiled. Got up like, okay, it's good. I lost that round. Got back to the game plan. And when they're in the close quarters, Ward was raking the hell out of Kovalev's body. Like, he was like, when they were going to break, one arm free, raking across the body. Like, take that with you. Ah! You know what I mean? And that's how I know he has dog in him. And you've seen, obviously the rematch. He showed you his dog. Terrence Crawford, very similar, because I've seen him trash talk a little bit. There's a couple guys like Hank Lundy, he pushed him hella hard. Darijan, they had bad beef. But you could tell by his demeanor, he's not for play. He has skills, and this is the thing I like about guys like this, is because they have that temperament and that mean streak, but it's all intelligent. It's not like, I'm gonna fight off pure emotion and fight a stupid game plan. But Crawford has dog. Like, for example, the Darijan post-fight interview. He says, they were interviewing him. They said, oh, you beat him. You stopped him. Lamont Peterson didn't stop him, but you stopped him. How does it feel? He said, this is what he said he wanted. So I'm wondering, did you get what you asked for? Like, on national TV, that's his response. It's like, I was just giving him what he asked for, basically. You know what I mean? Or you watch his fight with, like, Hank Lundy. There's some bad blood in the buildup. This dude, as he's knocking out Hank Lundy, he's sticking his tongue out and all kinds of stuff like that. That little mean streak, I'm telling you, it's them silent but deadly ones. Crawford, like I said, I've seen him trash talk, but more often than not, he's just cool, calm, collected, likes to spend time with his family. I follow him on social media. He likes to go fishing and, you know what I mean, just outdoorsy stuff and chill, kick it, play basketball, hoop, and stuff like that. But in that ring, the dude, he's a bad dude. I'm told you, I'm not really betting against him unless I see a superb threat. Like I told you, if he were to have fought Pacquiao, I would have picked him to beat Pacquiao because Pacquiao is not an intelligent fighter. And people get mad because they hear words. Oh, what? You said Pacquiao's not intelligent. Explain why he beat Margarito then. Like, you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. You could be intelligent and win, and you can be intelligent and lose. You can be a fighter who's not really intelligent and still win. You know what I mean? It just depends. Pacquiao has skills, but he doesn't, when it counts, he doesn't do some of the things that would have made the fight easy. Like, that's what I'm talking about. Championship level adjustments that we've seen from Ward, Floyd, Rigondeaux, Crawford, you know what I mean? Even Canelo. Canelo in that Lotta fight, I thought Lotta won it by a round or two, but learning from the Floyd fight, he did something different in the middle to late rounds, and he started abusing Lotta's body. He was like, oh, fuck this. This dude want to run, or he wants to use all this movement, and he started tattooing Lotta's body, and you've seen Lotta's offense drop. You know what I mean? You have to look for the signs. These are all good fighters that I'm talking about, and I see it. And, I mean, I've been in Crawford's gym in Omaha. It was cold as hell in the gym. It was a media day for the John Molina fight. That was my second time in Omaha. And it's cold as hell. He just comes in and gets to it, starts working, not really talking, he's just in the zone. And it's like, Terrence Crawford, he got the juice right now. Well, actually, let me rephrase that, because a lot of dumb motherfuckers don't understand. Like, what do you mean Terrence Crawford has the juice? He's juicing? He's on PEDs? Which one? Meldonium? Not like that. I'm talking slang, like Bishop and Juice. This scared! Terrence Crawford, he has the momentum right now, if that's better. Instead of he got the juice right now. Because I know a lot of y'all motherfuckers is, hey, Terrence Crawford, Eagle's saying you're on juice, man. But he got the momentum right now. And he has it. He's in the zone, if you will. And I just see it. I see it in his eyes. I see it in his performances. That Felix Diaz was not supposed to look like that. Because you put Felix Diaz in there with, there's a lot of guys I like. But even Adrian Broner. I don't think that fight would have looked like that. You know what I mean? Broner had a competitive fight with Emmanuel Taylor. So if Felix Diaz, who's fought at 47 just like Broner, were to scrap, I think that could be an all-out, like, you know what I mean, like a war. But it's Terrence Crawford. He knows what to do. He pumps that jab out there, and he tames you. He beats you down, breaks you down. Plus, he has power. And he can switch. Dude is bad, man. I'm looking forward to this Ndongo August 19th. Good fight. It's on ESPN. And guess what? Pacquiao Horn, which is a guy I never even heard of Horn, he did good numbers. So, you know what I mean? You could say, oh, Pacquiao's a bigger star than Crawford. But whatever. It's still on network TV with basic cable packages, ESPN. And that's a hell of a platform. So that's good. Even Lomachenko's fight, I mean, it's good that it's at least on ESPN. You don't have to have a premium network. But we got to start giving props to a lot of these American fighters, because a lot of them are going out. Like Ward, what he did, he heard the cries and the complaints. Oh, you robbed Kovalev. Okay. Rematched him. Handled business. Stopped him, even. Like, nobody stopped Kovalev. And now people want to talk about low blows and stuff. You know what I mean? Terrence Crawford, he's slaying Olympic gold medalists. He took on Victor Postol off of Postol's best win in his career, when Postol stopped Lucas Matisse and was a champion. And he dogged him. I was at the fight. I covered it live, front and center. I was like real close at that fight. You know what I mean? And he did his thing. And he's, like I said, he's eating up these Olympic gold medalists and shitting their medals out. Like, I don't care about that. I don't, what you did in the amateurs don't make me know, never mind. You know what I mean? And then now he's fighting the only other guy with belts in his division. You got to give these dudes props, because even Lomachenko, I fuck with Lomachenko. I like him stylistically, don't know him personally, but he can scrap. I like Lomachenko, but he's fighting a guy in a lower division who's moving up off of a loss and a knockdown in that loss to Oscar Valdez, right? And HBO is saying he's pound for pound number one. How? How has he passed Andre Ward, who has 30 plus fights, Crawford, 30 plus fights, and look at the challenges that they're currently taking? Not like, oh, Andre Ward, his super six, that's great. You can't forget about that. But I'm talking about his last two fights were challenges. Sullivan Barrera, who's in another fight in a couple weeks against Joe Smith Jr., that was a challenge. That's his first fight at the full weight. Crawford, same deal. He's fighting postals in recent memory. He's fighting another second Olympic gold medalist out of the DR in Felix Diaz, and he's destroying him. Now he's fighting the only other person in his division with belts to try to become undisputed on national network TV. And like I said, Lomachenko, he's fighting the guy that lost to the guy he beat in Nicholas Walters, because his opponent, Miguel Mariaga, he has two losses, and he got knocked down in both of them. One was Nicholas Walters and one is Oscar Valdez in a lower division. You got to give these American champions a lot of credit, because they're in more meaningful fights, at least comparing Ward and Crawford to Vasyl Lomachenko's. But at the end of the day, it's on ESPN, so that's a good thing, just like Pacquiao Horn, because I wasn't about to pay for that. I wasn't going to pay no pay-per-view for it. You know what I mean? Cody it is. You know what I mean? I keep it a buck. You guys say whatever you want about me. I ain't have no promoter. Just throw me no slop of food. Like, see, that's the thing. When you eating, like, some people are like, oh, hey, why wouldn't you pay for a pay-per-view? You make money in boxing. I don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, you can't. There's no way. You know how much money I've spent in boxing? Like going to Omaha twice. That shit wasn't free. Crawford didn't pay for it. I didn't have no Warren Buffett. Damn sure didn't pay for it. You know what I'm saying? Going to all these fights and stuff. So I don't have to prove nothing. I've shelled out tons of cash with no immediate return on investment. Just doing it for the culture. You know what I mean? So I'm not buying every pay-per-view that a promoter wants to put together if it doesn't make sense to me and if it's a fight I'm not really with. You know what I mean? If it's like, you know what I mean? Like something I think could be good, like Canelo Chavez Jr., I don't have a problem, but I wouldn't have paid for Pacquiao Horn. And I'm one of the realest people in this game because I speak my mind and I don't have no problem standing on my own too. That's just what it is. So, you know what I mean? People get mad like, oh, what? You're not going to buy Pacquiao Horn if it was on paper? Nope. I don't want to see that. But it turned out to be a good fight. So it's all good. It's all gravy. I'm just letting it know. Let it be known. Let me know what you guys think. Crawford is a dog. He is a beast. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Can Julius Ndongo trouble him? Let me know. Make sure you share the video. Like the video as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video is Ego Summit. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button. And you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego. The future of boxing.